If you're a new Christian, you may not be aware that God has told us that we can lay up eternal rewards in heaven for ourselves. Now understand, the free gift of salvation, or in other words, the forgiveness of our sins, because Jesus Christ paid the penalty for them by dying on the cross and taking our punishment for us, we can receive forgiveness by our asking Jesus to forgive us and our continued trusting that he will forgive us until we're done. That way we won't have them held against us on the judgment day like everyone else, and ultimately be sentenced to hell for them. However, and of course, you know, that is, there's no greater reward than being in heaven for eternity and staying out of hell. But God has said something else to Christians. He says we can lay up rewards for ourselves in heaven that we can assume will last for eternity. I'll read for you in Matthew 6, 19 through 21, if you're not familiar with this yet. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust destroy, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust destroys, and where thieves do not break in or steal. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. Jesus is the one speaking to us. Jesus, being God, knows what he's talking about, right? And one of the most effective ways to be used of God, well, I'm getting a little ahead of myself here, bear with me. There are two ways to be sure that you're going to be rewarded for your efforts in terms of laying up rewards for yourself in heaven. One is soul winning. Second is to help those lost souls that are now saved from the penalty of their sins grow in their relationship with Jesus Christ. So that's referred to as discipleship. Soul winning and discipleship are the two areas where you will receive rewards from God for helping in what is most important to him. You see, a redeemed soul, a lost soul saved, is more important to God than all the wealth of this world. Truly. And so soul winning is vitally important, and God uses people to help accomplish souls to be saved. And one of the most effective ways, there are many ways to go about helping God, working with God, to plant and water seeds of truth in the lives of others who have yet not heard the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ, which is what Jesus accomplished for us on the cross by paying the penalty for our sins. Many children have not heard that message. We assume everybody has probably heard that as adults, but you know, that can be an erroneous assumption. Furthermore, children have to be taught that. And many parents and the environment in which children are being raised in, they don't have parents telling them about the good news of what Jesus Christ accomplished for them on the cross. And so I've written up something called Jesus Did It. This is a flyer of Jesus Did It. It explains on one page briefly what Jesus accomplished for mankind on the cross, why he did it, and why we need to take advantage of what he did for us. And there are some other things there that are convincing, hopefully, of the fact that we need to have someone forgive us for our sins. And Jesus wants to. He wants to. And so these flyers, this Jesus Did It flyer, I'm encouraging people to be used of God to help lay up treasures for yourselves in heaven by distributing these. And there's a number of ways to distribute them, but one way is I encourage people to drop down in the description section below on this video clip, and there's a website link there. And click on that website, and you can print off a copy of this message, Jesus Did It, in any language around the world. There's a translate button there, and so you can print off a copy in the language you prefer, and then take that down to a local printer and make as many copies as you want to distribute however you feel the Lord would have you distribute them. There's many ways to distribute them. Putting them in restaurants, businesses where people can find them is one of the best ways. You can put them out in the highways and byways. You can fold them up. You can put them out like you would a Christian tract. There's many ways to. You can post them up on a bulletin board where people can see. You can tack them up against phone poles. There's just all kinds of ways you can distribute this out to where people can read it, get a hold of it. So I would encourage you, my friend, to seriously pray about this. Satan does not want Christians realizing how big of a deal this is. Christians are not being admonished nearly enough to be a spiritual investor. Lay up rewards for yourself and God, because God really indirectly will lay up rewards in heaven. When you lay up a lost soul to heaven, you've helped God to accomplish the most important thing that could be accomplished. And people, you know, can learn about God and when they're in heaven, but they've got to make a commitment to Jesus Christ first, and they have to know why they're supposed to. And that's what this Jesus Did It track is for. So thanks for hearing me out, and my friend, don't just waste your time now that you're a Christian. Make your time, your resources count. Go about laying up rewards for yourself in heaven. Yes, it's okay. We have to make a living. We have to provide. But we don't need to be so focused on living in this world that we neglect the most important reality, and that is we're going to spend eternity in heaven. And God has given us the opportunity to lay up eternal rewards for ourselves in heaven. Not everybody's going to get the same rewards. They're not. So, thanks, and God bless you.